感谢主我们弟兄姐妹都能够在一起来参加这个网络上的聚会。
Thank God that the brothers and sisters are able to join with this online service.
虽然这个困难时间看起来好像已经慢慢的来解开。
Although these difficult times seem to slowly be resolving itself.
但是我们在会堂里聚会这个事情到目前是还是不允许的。
However, we are still unable to go to church to worship.
所以我们求主耶稣在这方面来眷顾来施恩给我们，让我们每一个人能够早日回到会堂，大家一起来相见一起来聚集来敬拜神，来赞美神。
And we continue to put it in our prayers that the day may come sooner when we are able to physically go to church, that we may see each other face to face and to worship God together.
我想这也是我们每一位弟兄姐妹在期待的一个日子的来到。
And I believe this is a day that all the brothers and sisters are looking forward to.
所以虽然我们在网上聚会，
even though we are worshiping online,
我们也应该带着那一种严肃，就好像我们到会堂里头聚会一样专心用心来一起来分享主的话。
We likewise ought to have a reverent heart to listen to the word of God.
我们来继续来查考生命记的二十章。
So we continue to study Deuteronomy chapter 20.
我们请打开生命记的二十章。
Please turn to Deuteronomy chapter 20.
生命记的二十章一共有二十节。
Deuteronomy chapter 20 has 20 verses.
是非常短的一段圣经，一章圣经。
It's a relatively short chapter.
那小弟今天就把它分为两大段。
So I have split this into two sections.
第一段是从第一节到第九节。
The first section is from verse 1 to verse 9.
然后第二段是从第十节到二十节。
And the second section is from verse 10 to verse 20.
第一段第一节到第九节，我们先来看这个第一节到第四节。
Let's look at verse 1 to verse 4.
二十章的第一节，奉主耶稣圣名读经。你出去与仇敌征战的时候，看见马匹车辆并有比你多的人民不要怕他们。因为领你出埃及地的耶和华你耶和华神与你同在。第二节，你们要上阵的时候祭司要到百姓面前宣告说。第三节，以色列人啊，你们当听你们今日将要与仇敌征战不要胆怯不要惧怕战惊，也不要因他们惊恐。第四节，因为耶和华你们的神与你们同在同去，要为你们与仇敌征战，拯救你们。
Deuteronomy chapter 20 verse 1 to verse 4 in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ will read. Verse 1, when you go out to battle against your enemies and see horses and chariots and people more numerous than you, do not be afraid of them, for the Lord your God is with you, who brought you up from the land of Egypt. Verse 2, so it shall be when you are on the verge of battle, that the priest shall approach and speak to the people. 3, and he shall say to them, Hear, O Israel, today you are on the verge of battle with your enemies. Do not let your heart faint, do not be afraid, and do not tremble or be terrified because of them. Verse 4, For the Lord your God is he who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies to save you.
20章是谈到以色列人有关征战的这些条例。
So in chapter 20, it talks about the principles governing warfare.
神要告诉他们说，当他们进入迦南地以后呢，他们有了自己的国家。
And God was telling them that when they entered into the land of Canaan and they had their own country.
免不了的周围的其他国家可能也会来发起战争，要跟他们一起来打仗。
And it was inevitable that other countries would rise up and fight against them.
虽然他们没有去再去占领其他的，但是有可能别的国家也会来 想要来占领他们的土地。
Even though perhaps they have not, the Israelites have not gone out to wage war with other countries, but other nations may rise up to fight against the Israelites.
这里第二十章的第一节到第四节里头告诉我们。
So in verse 1 to verse 4, it tells us.
每一次他们出去征战之前有三次的宣告。
And when they, before they go out to battle, there are three times when they speak to them.
第一个就是由祭司来负责。
So the first is responsible by the priests.
然后接下来在第五节就是这个官长。
And in verse 5, the next is the officers.
然后第九节再由军长。
And verse 9 again is the officers, the commanders.
所以战争之前必定会有三次的宣告。
So on the verge of battle, there will be three times when people speak to the army.
至于祭司是代表神来讲话。
So for the priests, that is, they are the representative of God speaking to the people.
表明说这一次的战争神是许可的。
And that this battle is in the hand of God.
神会跟他们一起出去来征战。
God will go out to battle for them.
所以在第一节到第四节里头，我们发觉到。
So from verse 1 to verse 4, we find.
这里祭司就这样的来告诉他们。
The priests will tell them.
说你们跟仇敌征战的时候。
When you go out to battle against your enemies.
你会看到仇敌的马匹或者车辆或者他们的比对方的军兵比你多。
You may see that the horses and chariots and people are more numerous than you.
但是这里祭司告诉他们说，你们不需要来害怕。
However, the priests will tell them, do not be afraid.
因为带领你们出埃及的耶和华神会跟你们来同在。
For the Lord your God is with you, who brought you up from the land of Egypt.
所以呢，他们在打仗的时候祭司要这样的来去告诉他们。
So when they are on the verge of the battle, the priests will tell them these messages.
要让他们好好的来听祭司所讲的话。
In order for the people to listen to the words what the priests have said.
第三节里头，而且还要告诉这些出去打仗的人。
In verse 3, they also say.
不要胆怯，不要惊怕战兢，也不要因他们惊恐。
Do not let your heart faint. Do not be afraid and do not tremble or be terrified because of them.
但是这里是一个告诉他们要懂得有这种的认识。
And this is something that they had to recognize.
所以为什么呢？
Why?
第四节。
In verse 4.
因为耶和华你们的神与你们同去要为你们与仇敌来征战，来拯救你们。
For the Lord your God is he who goes with you to fight for you against your enemies to save you.
这个战争有神的同去跟神的同在。
This battle is with the abundance of God.
所以在这里要让他们知道说除了以色列人出去征战。
So here it is to tell them apart from the Israelites themselves going out to battle.
最后由他们的军长来带领他们出去。
And their commanders are to lead them out into battle.
但是这个战争是神跟他们同在的。
At the same time, God is with them.
所以当约书亚带领百姓进过了约旦河以后。
So after Joshua had led the people to cross the river Jordan.
有一天约书亚就去靠近这个耶利哥城。
There was one day where Joshua went near to Jericho.
我们来看一下这个约书亚记的第五章。
Let's turn to Joshua chapter 5.
约书亚记的第五章。
Joshua chapter 5.
第五章的13节到15节。
Joshua chapter 5 verse 13 to 15.
13节到15节。
Verse 13 to verse 15.
约书亚靠近耶利哥的时候，举目观看，不料有一个人手里有拔出来的刀，对面站立。约书亚到他那里，问他说：“你是帮助我们呢，是帮助我们敌人呢？”十四节，他回答说：“不是的，我来是要做耶和华军队的元帅。”约书亚就匍匐在地下拜说：“ 我主有什么话吩咐仆人？十五节，耶和华军队的元帅对约书亚说：“把你脚上的鞋啊脱下来，因为你所站的地方是圣的。”约书亚就照着行了。
13 And it came to pass when Joshua was by Jericho that he lifted his eyes and looked, and behold, a man stood opposite him with his sword drawn in his hand. And Joshua went to him and said to him, Are you for us or for our adversaries? 14 So he said, No, but as commander of the army of the Lord I have now come. And Joshua fell on his face to the earth and worshipped, and said to him, What does my Lord say to his servant? Verse 15. Then the commander of the Lord's army said to Joshua, Take your sandal off your foot, for the place where you stand is holy. And Joshua did so.
这是以色列百姓过了约旦以后所要第一次来攻下的这个坚固的耶利哥城。
So after crossing the river Jordan, the fortified city of Jericho was the city that they had to first overcome.
也是约书亚第一次当领袖带领这个百姓过约旦河以后所要攻取的这个城。
And this was the first city that Joshua had to take over once becoming the leader.
所以这里约书亚当他有一天靠近这个耶利哥城的时候。
So one day when Joshua drew near to Jericho.
这里说他举目就看到一个人手里有拔出来的刀。
Here it says he lifted up his eyes and he saw a man with a sword drawn.
而且是站在约书亚的前面。
He stood opposite Joshua.
约书亚就到他那里问他说，你是帮助我们还是帮助我们敌人呢？
Joshua asked him, are you for us or for our adversaries?
所以这个人的回答是这样。
And the response was,
他说我是来做耶和华军队的元帅。
As commander of the army of the Lord, I have now come.
虽然当时以色列人当中有他们的军长。
Even though within the army of the Israelites, they had their officers and commanders.
有约书亚作为他们的带领者。
And they had Joshua as their leader.
但是神要让他们知道。
But God wanted them to know.
主耶稣神才是他们耶和华的军队的元帅。
That God is their true commander.
主要来帮助他们。
In order to help them.
所以当约书亚听到这一句话以后，
After he heard this response,
他就立刻伏伏在地来下拜。
Joshua fell on the ground and worshipped.
说我主有什么话吩咐仆人？
And he said, What does my Lord say to his servant?
所以约书亚知道虽然他来接续了摩西带领的工作，
So Joshua knew that even though he had become the successor to Moses,
但是一路上的带领一路上的征战战争的胜利都是在神的手中。
All the guidance on the road and alsoIn the battles is within the hand of God.
所以刚才我们在生命记二十章里都所读到的。
So earlier what we read in Deuteronomy chapter 20.
祭司要告诉这些出去打仗的人。
The priests were to tell the men of war.
告诉他们不要来去胆怯不要来惊怕战惊也不要去惊惶。
To not let their hearts be faint, do not be afraid nor to tremble.
因为耶和华你们的神跟你们一起去。
Because the Lord your God is He who goes with you.
所以一场有神同在的战争他们一定会胜利。
So a battle with the abundance of God will be one that is victorious.
我们如果来看这个约书亚记的第六章。
If we look at Joshua chapter 6.
这里神就告诉约书亚说要怎么去攻下这个耶利哥城。
God tells Joshua how he is to overcome Jericho.
方法就是由祭司来带着百姓来围绕这个城，每一天围绕一次就六天都是这样做。
And the method was for the priests to guide the Israelites to walk around the city once each day.
大家都不可以讲话。
And no one was to speak.
到了第七天他们就要再来围绕这城七次。
On the seventh day, they were to walk around the city seven times.
又在前面带领他们的祭司来吹角。
And then the priests were to blow the ram's horns and the trumpets.
百姓听到以后呢，就要大声来呼喊。
And when the people heard this, they were to shout.
第五节告诉我们，这城墙就自动的这样来倒塌下来。
And in verse 5, it tells us that the wall of the city will fall down.
虽然耶利哥城非常的坚固。
Even though the city of Jericho was fortified.
但是这次的征战有神的同在。
However, this battle was with the abidance of God.
神跟他们一起出去战争。
God went out to fight for them.
他们就很轻易地把这个耶利哥城来拿下。
So relatively easily, they overtook and overcame the city.
当我们看到这个耶利哥城以后，他们要继续去来攻打这个埃城。
After Jericho, they were to continue to fight and to take the city of Ai.
我们发觉到当时百姓包括约书亚在内。
And we find that all the people were there, including Joshua.
他们并没有来求问神呐。
They had not inquired of the Lord.
而且呢，他们就觉得说这个城的人很少。
And they thought that the people of the city of Ai was much smaller.
所以呢，就决定说，只要两三千人上去，就能够很容易呢来取下这个埃城。
So they decided that with a few thousand people, they would be able to take the city.
结果以色列百姓在埃城人的面前呢，被打败了。
And as a result, they were defeated by the men of Ai.
也被埃城的人杀死了36位以色列人。
And there were 36 men who died because of this battle.
所以当时的约书亚跟众以色列的长老都非常的痛苦和灰心啊。And
so Joshua was very disappointed and very sad towards the elders.
我们来看一下这个第七章的第六节。Let's
turn to chapter 7, verse 6.
第七章的第六节。
Chapter 7, verse 6.
约书亚便撕裂衣服，他和以色列的长老把灰撒在头上，在耶和华的约柜前匍匐在地，直到晚上。Verse
6. Then Joshua tore his clothes and fell to the earth on his face before the ark of the Lord until evening. He and the elders of Israel, and they put dust on their heads.
他们不知道为什么会在这场战争会给打败。
But they did not know the reason why they were defeated in the battle.
他们一直以为说这个城是非常的小，他们应该很容易就可以把它拿下。
They thought that the city was small and weak and they would be able to easily win.
但是第七章十一节，神告诉了他们的原因。
However, in chapter 7, verse 11, God tells them the reason.
神告诉约书亚说，
God told Joshua,
以色列人犯了罪，
Israel has sinned,
违背了我所吩咐他们的愿，
and have also transgressed my covenant,
取了当灭的物，又偷窃，又行诡诈，又把那当灭的放在他们的家具里。
They have even taken some of the accursed things and have both stolen and deceived, and they have also put it among their own stuff.
所以14节的最后一句话，神告诉约书亚，
So in the last portion of verse 14, the Lord tells Joshua,
你们若不把那当灭的物从你们的中间来除掉，我就不再与你们同在了。That
if they do not remove of this, then God will not be with them.
虽然在生命记20章谈到说，这是神给他们战争的条例。So
in Deuteronomy chapter 20, this is the principle.
神会跟他们来同在。That
the Lord, their God, would be with them.
但是神的要求就是百姓必须要圣洁，要来遵行神的话。However,
the requirement is for the people to be holy and also to keep His commands.
所以当约书亚知道这个原因。So
when Joshua found out of the reason.
之后再把这个罪来除去。And
he had removed of the sin.
他们就再次去攻打这个埃城。
And they once again went to battle against Ai.
就把这个城来攻取了。
And they were victorious.
有时候让我们发觉到神在当时给他们这些战争的条例。
And we find that when God gives them these principles for warfare.
虽然神说我必定会跟你们同在，一起去战争啊。
Even though the Lord says that He will be with His people to fight these battles.
你们也不需要来胆怯或者去惧怕。
And the people ought not to be fearful nor to be afraid.
但是神也希望百姓懂得来怎么样来遵行神的吩咐。
However, there is a requirement that the Lord that the people of God will keep His commands.
大卫是神所喜爱的一位君王。
And David was a king that was loved by God.
我们来看这个撒摩耳记下的第六章。
Let's turn to 2 Samuel chapter 6.
撒摩耳记下第六章。第五章，对不起。
Sorry, 2 Samuel chapter 5.
撒摩耳记下第五章十九节。
2 Samuel chapter 5 verse 19.
十九节。
19.
大卫求问耶和华说，我可以上去攻打腓利士人吗？你将他们交在我手中里吗？耶和华说，你可以上去，我必将腓利士人交在你手里。
19. So David inquired of the Lord, saying, Shall I go up against the Philistines? Will you deliver them into my hand? And the Lord said to David, Go up, for I will doubtless deliver the Philistines into your hand.
我们再看撒母耳记下的第八章。
Let's also turn to 2 Samuel chapter 8.
第六节的下半段。
The second half of verse 6.
第八章的第六节下半段。
2 Samuel chapter 8, verse 6, the latter half.
大卫无论往哪里去，神都使他得胜。
So the Lord preserved David wherever he went.
这里这两段圣经告诉我们。
And these two verses tell us.
大卫为什么常常战争能够得胜呢？
Why is it that David was able to be victorious?
如果我们去查考大卫的这个历史的话，
If we look into the history of David,
每一次战争当中之前呢都会向神来求问神。
And before he went into battle, he would inquire of the Lord.
他跟神问神，神说可以去，他就去。
And when the Lord responded saying that he could go, then he would go.
所以这里神所给百姓所立的战争的条例
，So the principles regarding war
就是要他们知道说神会跟他们同在
，is to allow the people to know that God will be with them。
虽然我们今天肉体上没有像以色列百姓要真正出去来去跟人来征战
，Even though physically today we don't need to go out to fight in any battles，
但是这个属灵的征战却是非常的重要。
However, the spiritual battle is very important。
所以保罗他在写这个以弗所书的时候
，So when Paul was writing the book of Ephesians，
他这样的来告诉我们
，He tells us，
我们来看以弗所书的第六章
，Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 6。
请打开以弗所书第六章。
Ephesians chapter 6.
Ah, 第六章，我们来看这个十一节到十八节。
Verse 11 to verse 18.
这里是谈到要穿戴神所赐给我们的全副军装。
Here it tells us that we have to put on the whole armor of God.
十一节说就能抵挡魔鬼的诡计。
And verse 11, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
所以保罗告诉我们我们并不是跟属血气的来征战。
Paul tells us that we do not wrestle against flesh and blood.
我们今天所面对的战争是跟这个执政、掌权、管辖幽暗世界跟天空属灵气的恶魔。来征战
But against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places.
所以十三节保罗就告诉我们要拿起这个神所给我们全副的军装。
So verse 13, Paul tells us to take up the whole armor of God.
从十四节开始告诉我们，我们要把它穿上起来。
And in verse 14 onwards, it tells us that we have to gird on the armor.
我们每一个信徒每一位弟兄姐妹必须要去来好好去读这段圣经要知道怎么样把这个军装自己把它穿戴好。
And it's worthy for all of us to reflect on this passage and to equip ourselves with the armor of God.
保罗举例说十四节说要用真理当作这个带子束腰。
In verse 14, Paul tells us to gird our waist with truth.
用公义来当作这个复兴的镜来遮胸。
And to put on the breastplate of righteousness.
十五节说用平安的福音当预备走路的鞋穿在脚上。
Verse 15, to shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace.
再来要拿着这个信德当作藤牌可以来灭尽恶者一切的火箭。
16. Above all, taking the shield of faith with which you will be able to quench or the fiery darts of the wicked one.
还要戴上这个救恩的头盔。
17 and take the helmet of salvation.
最后要拿起这个圣灵的宝剑，就是神的道。
And the sword of the spirit, which is the word of God.
我们都准备好了没有？
Are we equipped?
我们要出去征战。
And we have to go out to fight.
虽然神会跟我们同在。
Even though God will be with us.
就好像这里第六章的以弗所书第六章的第十节告诉我们。
Just like verse 10 tells us.
保罗说你们要靠主。
You have to be strong in the Lord.
依赖他的大能大力。
In the power of his might.
就是圣灵的能力做一个刚强的人。
And to rely on the power of the Spirit to be strong.
我们要准备好自己。
We have to prepare ourselves.
因为从我们中间出去的有很多已经开始来对敌教会的这些传异端的工人。
Because from amongst us, there are many who have gone out to speak evil things and to go against the church.
所以我们必须要靠主来得胜。
And that's why we have to rely on God to be victorious.
他们为什么会离开呢？
Why is it that they have departed?
很多时候就是因为骄傲。
Many a times it's because of pride.
他们不愿意来听从教会的吩咐。
Unwilling to listen to the teachings and the admonishment of the church.
以前他们是跟我们一起来工作的。
Previously, they were co-workers with us.
但是现在却成为我们跟我们一起来攻击，就是成为我们的敌人。
However, they have now become adversaries.
所以呢，我们要好好的来穿上神所赐给我们的这个军装。
Which is why we have to put on and equip ourselves with the armor of God.
我们回来看这个二十章。
Let's turn back to Deuteronomy chapter 20.
所以神在这个战争的条例，希望他的百姓大家都要紧紧的记着。So
before they go into battle, the Lord wishes for the people to remember.
这是当时祭司们给他们的一些宣告。And
this was the proclamation that the priests were to make.
然后呢，这个从第五节到第九、第八节是谈到这些官长的向百姓的宣告。From
verse 5 to verse 8, this is what the officers will speak to the people.
他们说有一些呢，怎么样的人呢，不需要出去征战。And
there were certain types of people who were not to go out to fight.
有一种人就是正在建造自己的房屋。One
was someone who had just built a new house.
他还没有奉献，他可以回家去，他不需要去征战。
He had not dedicated his new house, so he was to return to his house and not to fight in the battle.
那些还在栽种葡萄园的。
Those who had planted a vineyard.
他还没有结果子，他也可以回家。
And had not eaten of the fruit, then he was to return.
那些刚刚聘定了妻，就是说刚刚要结要快要结婚的，他们也可以免去出去征战。And
those who were betrothed, then they were to return.
第八节。And
in verse 8.
那些是惧怕胆怯的，他们也可以回去。Those
who were fearful and faint-hearted, they were to return.
这些人都不适合去征战。
These were types of people who were not ready to fight.
我们都是主耶稣基督的精兵。
We are the soldiers of Christ.
所以呢，我们就不应该有世上的一些的顾虑。
So we must not be burdened or held back by the things of the world.
我们要很勇敢，跟着同工们一起出去为主来征战。
We have to be courageous to go out to fight the good fight.
好好的来装备自己。
To equip ourselves.
我觉得在这虽然封城期间。 很多事情都非常不方便。
I think during this time of the lockdown, although it's very inconvenient.
但是在祷告学习主的话，却是得到很多的益处。
But in prayers and learning the word of God, we have had many opportunities to grow.
也让我们在属灵上每一个人都能够更上一层楼。
And that we are able to grow in our faith.
所以这个长官告诉了他们以后，
So these officers had told the people.
第九节长官就把这个事情就交给当时的这个军长。
After speaking these things in verse 9, the officers will make captains.
就来率领他们出去来征战。
To lead the people to war.
第二段是从第十节到二十节。
The second part of the chapter is from verse 10 to verse 20.
这里是谈到说，他们怎么样来对待他们的仇敌啊。
And this is how they ought to conduct themselves against their enemies.
所以如果要出去征战
if they were to go out to fight,
第十节到第十六节
in verse 10 to verse 16,
首先他们到一座城要攻打的时候他们要到城里的居民来宣告
First, when they come near a city to fight against it, they have to proclaim,
要讲和睦的话
to give an offer of peace to the city.
十一节
in verse 11,
他们若以和睦的话回答你给你开了城城里所有的人都要给你效劳服侍你
Verse 11, and it shall be if they accept your offer of peace and open to you, then all the people who are found in it shall be placed under tribute to you and serve you.
如果这些人愿意这样做
if the people are willing to do this,
他们愿意来我们说愿意来投降
they are willing to surrender.
所以呢他们就应该呢不应该来杀他们
then the Israelites are not to kill them.
要用要把他们作为你们的奴仆
but to make them as servants
如果不肯跟你们和睦的话
however if they are not willing to accept the offer of peace
十二节
verse 12
若不肯与你和好反要和你打仗你就要围困那城十三节
13
耶和华你的神把城交付你手你就要用刀杀尽这城的男丁。
Verse 12, now if the city will not make peace with you, but makes war against you, then you shall besiege it. 13, and when the Lord your God delivers it into your hands, you shall strike every male in it with the edge of the sword.
所以这里神说如果他们不愿意和睦的话那只有去要动刀枪跟他们来打仗。
If they do not accept the offer of peace, then they have to go to war against the city.
要用刀把城里头的男丁都要杀死。
And all the males in the city are to be killed.
留下妇女孩子牲畜城内一切的财物。
But the women, the little ones, the livestock, and all that is in the city shall remain.
所以这是神给他们的一些吩咐。
So this is the commandment of God.
十七节。
17.
只要照耶和华你神所吩咐的，将这赫人、亚摩利人、迦南人、比利洗人、西魏人、也布斯人都灭绝尽尽尽。
17, but you shall utterly destroy them, the Hittite and the Amorite and the Canaanite and the Perizzite and the Hivite and the Jebusite, just as the Lord your God has commanded you.
这里是所提到的六族人是迦南地的人。
So here it records of the tribes of Canaan, and there are six of them.
所以神吩咐当时的以色列人，当他们进入迦南地的时候，必须要把这迦南六族完全来灭绝。
So for these tribes of Canaan, when the Israelites entered into the land of Canaan, they were to utterly destroy them completely.
这是神给他们的吩咐。
This was the command of God.
没有不需要跟他们来讲和睦的话。
And there is no need to give them an offer of peace.
神说要把他们灭绝，要把他们赶出去。
They were to utterly destroy them.
因为神已经把这个迦南地流奶与蜜之地来赐给了以色列人。
Because the land of Canaan, the land flowing with milk and honey, was promised to the Israelites.
所以在这里神特别的吩咐，要他们把这六族把他们赶走。或者把他们全部要灭绝。
So God especially commands them to utterly destroy these six tribes.
十八节。
Verse 18.
免得他们教导你们学习一切可憎恶的事，就是他们向自己神所行的，以致你们得罪耶和华你们的神。
18. Lest they teach you to do according to all their abominations which they have done for their gods.And you sin against the Lord your God.
所以这些事情神老早就给他们一个非常严厉的提醒。
So God had already very early on given them a very strict instruction.
进入迦南地要把这个六族来灭绝，把他们都赶出去。
Entering into the land of Canaan, they were to utterly destroy the tribes of Canaan.
不要有一天如果没有这样做的话，会给以色列人带来两个非常大的问题。
And the reason for this was because if they did not do so, then there would be two very great problems.
如果让他们留着跟他们一起来居住的话。
if they were left and there were remnants, they were allowed to live with them, then they would teach them things.
就会跟他们来通婚结亲。
And they would be given to marriages into the, with these people.
就会来影响他们这种纯正的信仰。
And it would corrupt the pure faith that they had.
让他使到他们的信仰就会破坏。
So that their faith would become corrupted.
所以这里很清楚地说会学习一切可真的事。
Here it tells us that lest they teach you to do according to all their abominations.
就是要去来引诱他们来学习怎么样来去敬拜迦南人所敬拜的这些偶像的神。
To influence them to worship the idols.
所以这里神是以一个纯正信仰的保守为一个重要的出发点。
So God has seen and emphasized with great importance the importance of a pure faith.
所以在这里我们发觉到摩西讲了这些话是要百姓知道为什么要这样去做。
And God told them this so they would understand why they had to do so.
要让他们知道说有一些事情他们必须要记着。
And there were these things that they had to keep in their hearts.
将来才不会导致自己的国家自己的子民信仰变成破产。
In this way, in the future, they would not cause the downfall of the people and also of the faith.
所以十八节这里说是学习他们一切可憎的憎恶的事情。
Verse 18 tells us, lest they teach you to do according to all their abominations.
生命记这个之前我们已经学习过他们拜偶像有不同的方法。
And previously in Deuteronomy, we have learned that there are various ways in which they worship their idols.
所以神要他们首先懂得来维护他们这个纯正的信仰。
So first, God wanted them to understand how to protect and preserve their pure faith.
必须要保持的这个神所给他们的这个诫命律例跟典章。
To keep the statutes, commandments, and these principles.
如果他们得罪神，离去了神。
If they have sinned against God and departed from Him.
神就不会跟他们同在。
God would not abide with them.
后来我们就发觉到，他们很多时候都是这样。
Later on, we see in the history that they often did so.
甚至在这个士师记的时代他们是更加的可怜。
And even in the time of the judges, it was very pitiful.
没有人来带领他们。
There were no leaders.
常常被外族来欺负。
And they were often oppressed by their enemies.
直到他们向神来呼求。
Until they cried out to the Lord.
神就为他们兴起士师来拯救他们。
And the Lord would raise up a judge to save them.
让他们来脱离这种外族人的手。
So that they can be separated from the hand of other nations.
为什么有这种的困难所遭遇的困苦呢？
Why is it that they had such trouble and sufferings?
就是因为他们信仰上离开了神。
It was because they had departed from God in their faith.
我们现在来看19节20节。
Let's look at verse 19 and verse 20.
19:20.
Verse 19 and verse 20.
你若喜酒围困攻城所要取的一座城，就不可举斧子砍坏树木，因为你可以吃那树上的果子，不可砍伐田间的树木，岂是人叫你糟蹋呢？20节，唯独你所知道不是结果子的树木可以毁坏砍伐可以建造营垒攻击那与你打仗的城直到攻塌了。
Verse 19, when you besiege a city for a long time, while making war against it to take it, you shall not destroy its trees by wielding an axe against them. If you can eat of them, do not cut them down to use in the siege, for the tree of the field is man's food. 20. Only the trees which you know are not trees for food you may destroy and cut down to build siege works against the city that makes war with you until it is subdued.
这里是神吩咐他们，当他们攻下一座城以后。
So here God is telling them that when they besiege a city,
不可以看到什么树木都把它们砍下来。
They cannot cut down any tree that they saw.
意思说生态 ecology. 不可任意来破坏。
So they could not corrupt the ecology.
他们只可以来用斧子砍下这些不结果子的果树。
They were only to cut down those trees with an axe, those which did not bear fruit for them to eat.
所以呢他们要留着那些会结果子的。
They were to leave of the trees that were man's food.
把其他的都可以把它们砍下来用来修筑这些营垒。
All others could be cut down to be used for the siege work.
我们发觉到这是神对当时百姓在这个战争的条例上的一些的规定。
So these were part of the principles that God had commanded the people.
神希望他们都能够照着神的话去做。
So God had wished that the people would be able to do this.
更重要的，他们必须要来听神的吩咐。
And for the people to keep his commands.
如果战争要每一次都得到神同去、神同在的话。
If they wished for God to be abiding with them and for the victory of the battle.
他们必须要遵守神的吩咐。
They also needed to keep this, which was part of the principles.
我们作为神的儿女，虽然今天我们肉体上不需要出去来征战。
And today, as children of God, although physically we do not need to go out to fight in a battle,
但是自从我们信了主耶稣以后，
but after we come to believe in Jesus,
我们就要穿上这个神所赐给我们的全副的军装。
We have to put on the whole armor of God,
好好的来装备自己，
to equip ourselves,
靠着圣灵所赐给我们的这个属灵的宝剑，
and to rely on the sword of the Spirit,
神的话。这个大能大力，我们一定能够作为一个刚强的基督徒。
And the word of God that we may be able to be a strong Christian.
我们的主耶稣会跟我们一起同在。
And our Lord Jesus will be with us.
让我们能够在每一场的战争当中都能够靠主耶稣来得到胜利。
That in every battle he will be there with us and we will be victorious.
我想这就是今天我可以跟大家来分享的地方。
And this is what I have to share for this chapter.
我们今天的早上的这个查经聚会就到这里。
So we end our Bible study this morning here.